Report immediately to the ready room for your level 1 qualification flight.
Well?
Nothing new right now. All quiet down here.
Sounds like I'm needed in the ready room.
Welcome, new recruits. Take a seat quickly. It's time to prove whether you have what it takes to be a part of our alliance. Deep space strike missions are among the most common assignments you'll receive as an Alliance starfighter pilot. The venerable Y-Wing and its more formidable successor, the B-Wing, are recognized as the preferred craft for deep space strike roles. The following exercise will assess your performance in a series of attacks against various targets. These mock combat situations are based on real events. They're designed to present increasingly difficult tactical problems. You are encouraged to repeat this exercise as often as possible. Try all of the available craft and armaments as you explore different tactics. You will follow your instructor on a series of offensive strikes against Imperial targets. The first target is the storage tanks at an Imperial Tabana gas processing facility. The facility is unprotected, but an attack will draw unwanted attention, so be quick. The next target will be an Imperial Carrick-class cruiser undergoing repairs at the Demorian repair yard near Drake 4.
Oh man. We're getting real with this stuff.
This facility is protected by a number of laser batteries. An Imperial base is close enough to send reinforcements within minutes of your arrival, so don't dally. The final target is an Imperial convoy transiting near Sertapa.
Oh, man.
It is a large convoy with inadequate escorts, so you should be able to inflict substantial damage.
This is really exciting.
You must destroy as much of the convoy as you can before the surviving vessels can escape into hyperspace. Return as soon as you are done.
Oh yes. This is when it gets real. I've got, what is that, an R5 or R4? Rather, R3? I forget. No, it's not R3, it's not an R2. I think that's an R4 and R5. Isn't it an R4? The R5s have the taller heads. Oh my god. Pilots and the others.
Alright.
Got some torpedoes loaded. Sounds good to me. Really liking this texture upgrade pack that I got, the X-Wing Alliance upgrade. Although, where my legs go? I guess I go it's tight fit in here. But I've got a nice panoramic view of everything from my Y-Wing, my space tank. Alright, let's take off. Let's see how this thing handles. 10 torpedoes. Cargo containers destroyed, Imperial convoy at least 25% destroyed, and destroy the CRK.
Shuttle landing.
Oh, hello there. I just want to savor this moment. This is exactly why I installed this game. This is what I was looking for.
Alright, rookie, let's begin. Follow me to the first target area. Hey man, I was really sorry to hear about what happened to your family. But I'm glad you've decided to join the rebellion. Just remember, this isn't about revenge. It's about fighting injustice and tyranny. We're gonna bring the Empire down. And put an end to tragedies like what happened to your family.
Okay, let's see how this goes.
The platform is dead ahead. Target the nearest objective, Oki, and destroy it. Remember to return to the Defiance when you wish to rearm.
Okay.
see how the explosion causes damage to everything near it? Now destroy the rest of the containers.
Report on secondary target. They're sealed around. Report on secondary target. Their hull is heavily damaged. Report on secondary target. They've been destroyed.
Now follow me to the next target area. Looks like we've attracted some attention. Let's go!
Attacking craft, dead ahead. Hey, one, there's a bandit going for missile lock.
Well, if you want to play, I'm game. I like your aggressive spirit. We can use pilots like you. Notice how well defended this target is. In a situation like this, you should use standoff tactics. Switch to warheads and target the cruiser Sodrap. Notice that depending on your angle of attack, your warheads may hit the repair yard instead of the target. In that case, try changing your angle of attack. Or targeting a specific component of the cruiser, to which you have a clear line of fire. The other thing that you have to worry about is defensive fire that'll destroy your warheads. This may require you to dumbfire your warheads. That is, launching warheads without using your targeting system.
Primary target update. Their hull is damaged. primary target update. Their hull is heavily damaged.
Keep it up!
Report on primary target. They've been destroyed.
This time the opposition is more serious. I recommend we go.
I could use some help!
You're really gung-ho. Be careful you don't take on too much.
Hey, one! Dive!
Primary target update. Their shields are out. They've been destroyed.
Good start. Keep going and get as many as you can.
Primary target update. Their shields are out. Report on primary target. Their hull is heavily damaged. They've been destroyed. Report on primary target. Their shields are out. Primary target update. Their hull is heavily damaged. They've been destroyed. Report on primary target. Their shields are out. Report on primary target. Their hull is heavily damaged. They've been destroyed. Primary target update. Their shields are out. Primary target update. Their shields are out. Primary target update. They've been destroyed. Report on primary target. Their shields are out. You've attacked a friendly craft. Primary target update. They're sealed the route. Primary target update. They've been destroyed.
You've demonstrated sufficient skill to fly strike missions. Congratulations. You only have to pass one more qualification. Very respectable. You've done a lot of damage.
Report on primary target. They've been destroyed.
Well, whatever that little strike craft with all those lasers was, I don't like it at all. And I don't want to have to fight one of those for a while. I don't know how many times it took me, how many tries it took me to kill that or to not die to it. That has way too many cannons. Whew, let's go home.
Landing.
Well done. You have proven competence in performing the deep space strike role and the proper employment of a variety of heavy warheads and countermeasure systems. You are now ready for the second part of the starfighter qualification tests. Given the huge advantage in military strength the Galactic Empire possesses relative to the Rebel Alliance, our primary tactic is the hit-and-fade strike. There is simply too much to be defended, and despite the overwhelming size of the Imperial Starfleet, it cannot be everywhere all the time. Whatever is left undefended, we will attack.
Ace, I have news.
All level one qualified recruits, report to the ready room.
You had better report to the ready room.
That's what you had to tell me, old buddy? If you're considering joining the Rebellion, then consider teaming up with a fighter group that's proven itself over in combat, Blue Group. Oh man, Red and Blue and all these guys. I know you're as upset as I am about Dad and Galen. I can't believe they're gone. We have to be strong right now, as a family, as well as individuals. Don't let what's happened distract you. I don't want to lose you too. Well, if the Empire keeps sending those gunboats after me, I might not make it too much longer.
All level one qualified recruits report to the...
Okay, let's get down to business. You will be assessed on your ability to engage a variety of targets in mock combat situations. You may select from any of the available starfighters and armaments. The recognized primary craft for this role are the Superb X-Wing and the increasingly popular A-Wing. It is assumed that you possess basic flight skills and weapons training. This test will evaluate your strengths as a solo dogfighter, then as part of a flight element of two craft, next as part of a flight group of four craft, and finally as a member of a full squadron of 12 fighters. You will face a gradually escalating series of challenges. More important than your skills as an individual will be your abilities as a member of a team. You will deploy from the Alliance cruiser Liberty. Follow your instructor, Lieutenant Garn, to the first target area, where you will begin the evaluation. In target area 1, you will engage in a series of mock dogfights against the Empire's principal space superiority starfighter, the TIE, or Twin Ion Engine Fighter. Lieutenant Garn will observe. Next, you will work with Lieutenant Garn as a two-ship flight element in another series of dogfights against the TIE Interceptors, a more recent and far more capable space superiority fighter. In target area 3, you will be joined by another two-ship element to fight yet another series of dogfights against equal and then greater numbers of enemy starfighters. In the final test, you will fly as part of an entire squadron in a massive engagement against multiple enemy squadrons featuring a variety of starfighters, some of which are armed with concussion missiles. You will deploy from the Alliance cruiser Liberty.
So it really sounds like I'm doing a lot of training stuff, kind of in well, I mean, I'm here in the hangar, but it, I don't know. It just sounds like simulation work.
Tackle the party.
Your new craft will be prepared at once, sir.
Oh, wow. Okay, so I could try the headhunter. This is more like a scouting craft. I could try the B-wing.
All systems check out in your new craft. It's ready to fly.
Man. Neat. Very neat.
Your new craft will be prepared at once, sir.
Man, I feel vulnerable in this, but it's also really cool. You know what? I'm gonna stick with the X-wing.
Your new craft
just for
will
now.
Be prepared at once, sir.
After all, this is X-Wing Alliance. I wonder what the difference between a missile and a...
Your new warheads will be loaded immediately, sir. Your new warheads will be loaded immediately, sir. Your new warheads will be loaded immediately, sir. New countermeasures have been loaded.
Target the nav buoy and we'll be on our way.
Hey, two! Attacking craft, head ahead!
It's one click away and we'll now attack you. Set your throttle to one-third and evade at once. Now two enemy craft will attack you simultaneously. Notice that the appropriate threat warning indicator is lit. Once you've evaded the enemy attack, you must counter. Good job. One down and one to go. Now let's see how well you handle an attack by three enemies. Good start. Now you're only facing 2-1 odds.
Wow!
Finish off the last one, and we'll give you a serious challenge.
We'll be right back.
Care to try 4-on-1?
Hey, 2, you better shake that bandit off your 6.
Hyperspace to the next target area. 2 ship element. I will now join you, and we'll work together. We'll bracket the target and attack it from 2 angles. I'll break to the right while you break to the left. I'll take number 1. You take number 2.
Sarcasm, buddy.
Little bit of a challenge here. Do we concentrate on one of the 2 flight elements, or do we split up and each of us take on a different element? There is no perfect answer. You have to play it by ear. That evens things up nicely. Let's finish him off. Got our hands full, but I'm sure you can handle it.
One less imp to worry about.
You've attacked a friendly craft.
Take that.
Hyperspace to the next target area. Four ship group. Protect one another. It's also risky because you can accidentally hit each other.
Hey, two! Enemy in range! Yeah! Whoa! Imperial training seems a bit lax! This is three. I'm having trouble over here. That's one less imp to worry about. Gotta keep it up.
Hyperspace to the next target area. 12 ship squadron. TIE bombers aren't much in a dogfight.
This is Seven. I'm under heavy fire.
Unless they're armed with concussion missiles.
This is Six. I've got a starship firing at me. Another bandit down.
Chalk up another one.
Got him. One less imp to worry about. Whoa! This is three. I've got a starship firing at me. This is four. I'm under heavy fire.
Congratulations, you have demonstrated satisfactory skills. Consider yourself ready for immediate assignment.
This is 4. I need assistance, fast.
Great work out there, Adamine.
Well done. You have shown competence in performing the space superiority role. This test confirmed your tactical abilities in the following circumstances. In 1v1, 1v2, and 1v many. As part of a flight element in 2v1, 2v2, and 2v many. And as a member of a group or squadron in many-versus-many situations. Given the great disparity in strength between the Galactic Empire and the Alliance, we must always seek whatever relative advantage we can. Thus, we avoid direct confrontations against the Empire's main strength, instead relying on stealth and surprise to launch sneak attacks where Imperial forces are weak, and we can attain a temporary local superiority.
I received new mail for you.
Congratulations on your promotion!
Oh, I've been promoted to Flight Cadet. And I've got a whiskey? Tauntaun Splash on Cologne. Imported from Hoth, this cologne has never made much progress in the galactic market. No one in your family seems to know how it got into your cabin. Okay. Must be a girl aboard here? Alright, urgent! Hey bro, I'm going to be talking to your commanding officer soon about getting you some time off. Aaron's not around and I need your help. I'll tell you more when I see you. Green 7. Hi, my name is Jorgis. I heard your group has been activated too, so I thought I'd wish you luck. I joined about the same time you did, and it's somehow comforting to know that I'm not the only rookie going out today. Good luck to us. If you don't hear from me for a little while, don't worry. I'm off to do some serious slicing, so I'll be keeping a low profile. Talk to you soon. So I'm deploying. Awesome. Whoops. Well? I will see you all next episode.
Tonight's scheduled Hollow movie has been canceled. Sorry for the inconvenience.